यस, क्वेश्चन नंबर 95। कैलकुलेट ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर इन ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग अल्टरनेटिव केसेस। केस वन, नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स इज गिवन 4 लाख एंड एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज गिवन 1 लाख। डायरेक्टली वी कैन कैलकुलेट, है ना? केस वन, ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो, नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, इट इज गिवन 4 लाख एंड 1 लाख। 4 लाख एंड 1 लाख इज इक्वल टू 4 टाइम्स। वेरी सिंपल, है ना? केस टू, लेट ओके, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन 30 लाख, एंड कैश सेल्स इज गिवन 6 लाख। वी सब्ट्रैक्ट कैश सेल्स 6 लाख, व्हाट वी गेट? 24 लाख। ओके, एंड ओपनिंग इज 2 लाख एंड क्लोजिंग इज 6 लाख। ओके, सो एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज इक्वल टू 2 लाख प्लस 6 लाख डिवाइड बाय 2, सो एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल विल बी 2 प्लस 6, 8 डिवाइड बाय 2, 4 लाख, एंड ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो विल बी नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, दैट विल बी 24 लाख डिवाइड बाय 4 लाख इज इक्वल टू 6 टाइम्स, है ना? 4 6 24, 6 टाइम्स। ओके, इस 3, कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज गिवन 3 लाख, ओके, एंड ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 25% ऑन कॉस्ट, सो ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 25% मीन्स 75,000। कैश सेल्स इज 20% ऑफ टोटल सेल्स, कैश सेल्स इज 20% ऑफ टोटल सेल्स, एंड ओपनिंग टी आर एंड क्लोजिंग टी आर इज गिवन 50 एंड 1 लाख। ओपनिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज गिवन 50,000 एंड 1 लाख। ओके, 50,000 एंड 1 लाख। लेट मी कैलकुलेट टोटल सेल्स फर्स्ट। टोटल सेल्स इज इक्वल टू सी ओ जी एस प्लस ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट। टोटल सेल्स इज इक्वल टू सी ओ जी एस इज 3 लाख प्लस ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 75,000, एंड टोटल सेल्स विल बी 3,75,000। ओके, नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन, कैश सेल्स इज 20% ऑफ टोटल सेल्स, यस और नो? तो लेट अस कैलकुलेट कैश सेल्स। कैश सेल्स इज 20% ऑफ टोटल सेल्स, सो 20% ऑफ 3,75,000 Let us calculate 20% of 3,75,000. 75,000. And we need credit sales. And credit sales, how do we calculate credit sales? Credit sales means total sales minus cash sales. Very simple. So credit sale will be, total sale is 3,75,000 and cash sale will be is 75,000. So credit sale is now 3 lakh. Okay. So credit sale is computed. We need to compute average trade receivable. Average trade receivable is ओपनिंग प्लस क्लोजिंग डिवाइड बाय टू, सो 50,000 प्लस 1 लाख डिवाइड बाय टू, सो इट विल बी 75,000। एंड ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो विल बी नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स, दैट इज 3 लाख अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, दैट इज 75,000 इज इक्वल टू 4 टाइम्स। नाउ इट इज क्लियर, है ना? देयर इज वन मोर केस, आई थिंक दिस इज केस नंबर 3। One more case is given, case 4. Let's see what is given in case 4. Cost of goods sold is given 4,50,000. Cost of goods sold is given 4,50,000. Gross profit on sales is given 20%. Gross profit on sales is given 20%. Cash sales is 25% of credit sales. Okay. Cash sales 25% of credit sales. Opening trade receivable 90 and closing 60. Opening trade receivable is 90,000. Closing trade receivable is 60,000. Okay. What is needed to calculate credit sales? We need to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. To calculate trade receivable turnover ratio, we need net credit sales upon average trade receivable. And to get net credit sales, we need total sales. Hai na? Yes or no? So according to given information, gross profit on sales is 20%. Yes or no? So let us assume that sales is X. If sales is X, gross profit will be 20% of sales. So X into 20% is equal to X by 5, yes or no? And children, we know that sales minus gross profit is equal to cost of goods sold, yes or no? So if we have assumed sales is X, gross profit will be X by 5 and cost of goods sold is given in the 4,50,000. By using this equation, we can easily calculate this. So X minus X by 5 is equal to 4X by 5 is equal to 4,50,000. And by cross multiplication, we will get X is equal to 5 multiply by 4,50,000 divide by 4. Yes or no? Let me calculate. 5 into 4,50,000 divide by 4. 5,62,500. So this is our net sales. And according to the question, you can see it is given that cash sales is 25% of credit sales. And we do not know what is credit sales. But we know one information. We know one information that credit sales, this is next working note, credit sales plus cash sales is equal to total sales. Yes or no? And we have total sales, the 5,62,500. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन इन्फॉर्मेशन हियर इट इज मेंशन कैश सेल्स इज 25% ऑफ क्रेडिट सेल्स. इट मीन्स इफ क्रेडिट सेल्स इज एक्स, सपोज कैश सेल इज 25% ऑफ एक्स. 25% मीन्स 25 अपॉन 100. इट मीन्स 1/4 मीन्स एक्स बाय 4. इट मीन्स कैश सेल्स इज एक्स बाय 4. टोटल सेल्स विल बी 5,62,500. So when we solve this equation, what we get? X plus x by 4, 5x by 4. When we solve, take LCM, is equal to 5,62,500. Let us cross multiply. When we cross multiply, we get 4 multiplied by 5,62,500 divided by 5. So 5,62,500 into 4 divided by 5, we get 4,50,000. Now what is this 4,50,000? Credit sales. This is what is needed. Yes or no? This is what is needed. Credit sales. Now we need average receivable. Hai na? Average trade receivable. And average trade receivable means opening trade receivable plus closing divided by 2. And opening and closing both are given in the question. 90 and 60. So 90,000 plus 60,000 divided by 2. Average trade receivable is equal to 1,50,000. Divide by 2, that is 75,000. So we have credit sales, we have average trade receivable. So we can calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. Net credit sales will be 4,50,000. Divide by average trade receivable 75,000. So let us calculate. 4,50,000 divided by 75,000 is equal to 6 times. Anna, I hope it is clear to everyone. From the information given below, calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. Okay, credit sales 8 lakh, question number 96. Credit sales is given 8 lakh opening trade receivable 1,20,000 closing trade receivable 2 lakh trade receivable turnover ratio means net credit sales upon average trade receivable. We calculate average trade receivable, opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divide by 2. So 2 plus 1, 3,20,000 divided by 2, so 1,60,000 average trade receivable. Credit sale is 8 lakh divided by average trade receivable 1,60,000. So trade receivable turnover ratio will come 5 times. Okay, now the question begins. State giving reason, which of the following would increase, decrease or not change trade receivable turnover ratio. So first point, collection of trade receivable 40,000. Collection of trade receivable, how much? 40,000. Tell me, dear children, when we receive trade receivable, how will it affect our ratio? Will it affect net credit sales? Huh? Collection of trade receivable? Huh? Tell me, dear children, will it affect net credit sales? It will it will not affected na net credit sales. There will be no change. Net credit sales remain same 8 lakh rupees. Whatever it is there, Now will it affect your average trade receivable?
Yes, sir.
When you received trade receivable, your average trade receivable will reduce. Yes or no? Because closing trade receivable will reduce. When you receive 40,000 rupees trade receivable, your closing trade receivable will reduce, which will ultimately reduce your average trade receivable. So this will reduce. When there is a change in average trade receivable, it is reduced, and there is no change in net credit sales, ultimately what will happen? Ultimately, trade receivable turnover ratio will increase. Yes or no? Because it is already given 5 times. And if average trade receivable reduce, the times will increase. Yes or no? I hope it is clear to everyone. Let's see one more point. Second point. Credit revenue from operation means credit sales is 80,000. Okay. Credit sales is 80,000. How will it affect our ratio? Net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Will it affect or not? Let us use these values which are given here. Credit sale was 8 lakh. So now credit sale will be 8 lakh plus 80,000. Yes or no? So now credit sale will be 8 lakh 80,000. Average trade receivable. So opening and closing is given. Closing trade receivable is 2 lakh. Now it would be 2 lakh 80,000. Because of credit sales, trade receivable will also increase. So 2 lakh 80,000. So let's calculate average trade receivable. Average trade receivable will be 1 lakh 20,000 plus 2 lakh 80,000 divide by 2. So let us solve it. Let me solve it. 1,20,000 plus 2,80,000 divided by 2. So 4 lakh divided by 2, 2 lakh. So average trade receivable will be 2 lakh now. So let's calculate 8,80,000 divided by 2 lakh. How much we get? 4.4 times. And earlier it was 5 times, now it is 4.4 times. Yes or no? Hence, trade receivable turnover ratio will decrease. Is that clear, dear children? In this manner, yes. You need to solve and explain in the examination also, dear children. Sometimes, somewhere, you need to explain by using examples, using figures. And these questions are nowadays part of the CBSE and examination everywhere. So you have to learn. Finding any difficulty, ask. Third point. Sales return 20,000. Okay? sales returned 20,000. Formula of trade receivable turnover ratio is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. So let's check. How much credit sale was given to your children? 8 lakh. 8 lakh it was given. Will it affect net credit sale? Yes, because of sales return, the value will decrease. Hai na? Will it affect average trade receivable? Yes, because average trade receivable will also be affected. Opening trade receivable is given 120,000 plus closing trade receivable is given 2 lakh, so it will also be decreased by 20,000, so 180,000 divide by 2. So let us solve it. 3 lakh divided by 2, 150,000. Hai na? Average trade receivable. So 150,000 is average trade receivable. 8 lakh minus 20,000, 7 lakh 80,000 divide by 150,000. So let us divide it. 7,80,000 divided by 1,50,000, 5.2 times means it is more than 5 times, hence the ratio improves. Hence trade receivable turnover ratio increases. I hope it is clear. Let us see, there is one more case which is given. Credit purchase 1,60,000. Okay. Fourth point. Credit purchase of rupees 1,60,000. How will it affect trade receivable turnover ratio? Trade receivable turnover ratio, net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Net credit sales was given 8 lakh, and because of credit purchase, it has been increased by 1,60,000. Okay? Yes or no? Credit purchase of rupees 1,60,000. Sorry, net credit, no. Credit purchase will not affect net credit sales. Yes. This is credit purchase. So there will be no change in net credit sales. It is credit purchase. Yes. No change in net credit sales. And hence, because it is purchase now, there will average trade receivable will also be not affected. Hai na? Average trade receivable was given 1,60,000. No change, so 5 times. So credit purchase will not affect net credit sales, will not affect average trade receivable. Hence the ratio will not change. Hence trade receivable turnover ratio not changes. Isn't it?
Sir, please scroll up.
Which one? This one?
Third one,
okay. You can see.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think all these cases are clear to everyone. Hai na? Now what happened now? Achha. Okay, let's see question number 97. Many questions are given here. So 1,75,000 is the credit revenue from operation, credit sales. Credit sales 1,75,000. If trade receivable turnover ratio is 8 times, trade receivable turnover ratio is given 8 times. Calculate trade receivable in the beginning and at the end of the year. Trade receivable at the end is 7,000 more than that in the beginning. It means if we take opening trade receivable as X, then closing trade receivable will be more by 7,000, so X plus 7,000. We need to calculate trade receivable in the beginning. Okay. So we can calculate very easily. We have the formula of trade receivable turnover ratio, that is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. By putting the value in the formula, 8 times is equal to net credit sales 175,000 divided by average trade receivable, and we can get average trade receivable is equal to 175,000 divided by 8. And average trade receivable is now 175,000 divided by 8, 21,875. Now we have more formula of average trade receivable. Average trade receivable means opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2. So average trade receivable is equal to opening is given and closing is given X plus 7,000. X plus 7,000 divided by 2. Average trade receivable we have computed 21,875 is equal to 2X plus 7,000 divided by 2. Let us cross multiply. So 21,875 multiply by 2, 43,750 is equal to 2x plus 7,000. Yes or no? And then 2x is equal to 43,750 minus 7,000. And then 2x is equal to 43,750 minus 7,000, 36,750. Just a minute, it is 36,750. And X is equal to divide by 2, 18,375. This is your opening trade receivable, yes or no? Can calculate closing trade receivable is equal to 18,375 plus 7,000. 18 plus 7, 25,375. I hope the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children.